So apparently the president of Square Enix has decided to come out and make a statement concerning the actual usage of NFTs in future Square Enix games for 2023 and moving forward. Now I know what you're thinking to yourself, Alex, it's 2023. Who the hell's talking about NFTs anymore? I mean, they're dead. But wait a minute, I feel like we've talked about this before. Yeah, we did talk about this before. In fact, we talked about this 11 months ago when the Square Enix president said the same thing last year. So we didn't just double down. No. We are now tripling down in the actual scam of NFTs, let alone the fact that crypto is basically in the toilet. Ethereum has moved to proof of stake, and this is what we've become. We are now watching Square Enix literally have massive diarrhea all over their entire back catalog of RPGs from PS1 and PS2 and even SNES that they could literally just remake today and make billions of dollars on. But no, instead, we're gonna throw our hat in the gambling ring of NFTs after everything that's happened in 2022. If you didn't have Yoshi P, you would literally be defunct by now. Let's not take my word for it though, let's take a look at the article from VGC and see what they had to actually say. Square Enix believes recent blockchain volatility can benefit its game plans. The Japanese publisher again used its New Year letter to discuss its aggressive investment. In a new letter discussing its plans for 2023, Square Enix president Yosuke Matsuda has now said blockchain remains the biggest focus for its medium to term investments, despite what he called volatility in the blockchain space in 2022. Matsuda argued that lessons learned and likely regulation to come could benefit the growth of the blockchain field and its plans to develop games based on the technology. My boy, what games? There's no games you want to base on the technology. And how are NFTs going to even work in games? You mean the scam that everybody was trying to promote who never actually developed a game in the first place? You mean the whole like buy this NFT item and then use it across every single game as an NFT? Did you not understand how stupid that was in the beginning? How easily debunked it was by literally anybody who had an iota of intelligence of game design and how games actually worked? You're the president of Square Enix. You sit on the largest repository of RPGs literally ever made, and your entire thought process is, you know, those NFTs were looking pretty good. We should keep doing that. Why do you want to keep doing the Beanie Baby fad of 2022? That's exactly what it was, by the way, because these things are long gone. I mean, look at Meta, look at Facebook, look at the millions and billions of dollars being lost, and you think regulation is going to fix the NFT market? My boy, Logan Paul has a crypto to sell you, and I'm sure you'd buy in. In terms of new business domains, we named three focus investment fields under our medium-term business plan. Among these, we are most focused on blockchain entertainment, to which we have devoted aggressive investment and business development efforts. Looking externally, I think it is fair to say that blockchain gained significant recognition as a field in 2022, as evidenced by Web 3.0 becoming a firmly established buzzword among business people. How is it that even in your own statement, in your own letter, you literally wrote the word buzzword and you didn't think to yourself, oh, maybe that's exactly what it is, a buzzword, a marketing gimmick, a scam, a literal rug pull, and you're going to turn your medium-term investments into this. Delete the last 30 years, 40 years, probably even more, of actual IPs and games and game catalogs that you have at your disposal. You can easily turn around and sell and remake or remaster and literally turn a profit, but no. Put everything on the back of Yoshi P and say, hey, you know what? We're doing this NFT thing because nobody else is doing it anymore, because that ship sailed back by like what? September, October? It was basically gone. Nobody talked about it or thought about Web 3.0 then. Square Enix is doomed. Square Enix is literally doomed. However, the year also saw volatility in the cryptocurrency and NFT markets that tracked the dramatic shifts in the macroeconomy described above. The latter half of the year in particular produced a somber string of news stories with blockchain connections, including the scandalous bankruptcy filing of FTX in November. In the wake of these developments, we hear rumblings from some countries of early moves to regulate such businesses more strictly. In Japan, meanwhile, the drive to encourage such business has gained momentum, led by the government.
How do you sit there and literally have the gall, the audacity, the gumption, the testicular fortitude to literally write down how FTX scammed billions of dollars, with a B, mind you, in this entire market of crypto, and you have... And you think that because Japan wants to regulate it in some fashion, that it's going to be all okay. You know, if you don't know about FTX, go look up CoffeeZilla. He did a phenomenal expose about the whole thing, Sam Bankman-Friedman, and he just ripped the dude to shreds. A single YouTuber, a guy who wears suspenders, by the way, who's very dashing and handsome, literally disrupted and destroyed an entire market by himself by making YouTube videos. And this is what you want to do. This is the market you want to get into. Are you sure about this? Are you sure you've ever done anything business-wise properly? I feel like you don't know what you're doing. And I feel like anybody who is anybody with a half a brain cell can figure this out, that you're doing the wrong thing. However, in the wake of the aforementioned turbulence in the cryptocurrency industry, there is now a trend to view blockchain technology as a mere means to an end and to discuss what needs to happen to achieve the end of delivering new experiences and excitement to customers. I see this as a very beneficial development for the future growth of the industry. No, you don't. What you see is a possible future of you growing the pocketbook of Square Enix, even though this is a literal dead horse of a market. The NFT bubble has burst. It has been proven to be a scam. Cryptocurrency has in fact burst because of NFTs. I don't care what crypto bros say, y'all got scammed the last 2 years. Take your L and take it to the bank. By the way, the bank that you no longer have because you devoted all your money into literally fake money, which you are now trying to pawn off as actual value. But hey, let it be known, the fact that you are no longer wanting to actually have games and game developments and have people play games, you want people to actually try to earn in a video game. The thing is this though, people don't want to actually have to earn anything in a video game. They want to have the thing that's just one simple word with three letters, F, U, and N, fun. Remember that? Remember when games used to be fun? When you played a video game to either have fun, either having fun by completing an objective or getting better at the game, or just having a game that just actually had some soul to it. People who actually developed the game that wanted you to actually have a good time playing it. Not just check off a list of vomited icons onto a map. But yet here we are, another developer still clinging on to the entire NFT market and cryptocurrency and Web 3.0 as if playing to earn is a good thing. No, we are not here to be in your sweatshops so that you can earn all the cryptocurrency money. And then that way we get to earn what, 1/100th or 1/1000th of a cent every time we get a special item that you can literally just remake because they're ones and zeros. There's no actual value to them besides the value that you've placed onto them in general that have no real actual monetary compensation. Oh, that's what you want. What you're trying to do is push forward a market that's actually gone, that won't come back, that is literally just a side note in the footnote of history because everybody was bored at home and had GPUs in 2020 to 2022. And you know, this really just burns my ass because the thing is, Square Enix could literally be one of the best developers and publishers in the gaming space today because they have the best collection of IPs, of JRPGs, and just video games. So I'm sorry, they used to until they gave it all to, basically just gave it, by the way, all to Embracer. They could have done so much more with what they had, but they're too busy squandering their own talent and what they can actually do. I grew up with Squaresoft in the 90s, okay, when I was a teenager, and their games were the literal masterpieces of their time. Anything Squaresoft touched was freaking gold. And the actual thing that we've always loved has now become the villain. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you guys so much for watching this video. I'm sorry that I went off on a tangent on this one, but the thing is this, I absolutely hate NFTs. I hate what gaming has become, and the entire term of modern gaming about playing to earn and just checking off a box and user engagement and all that stuff really just puts a chaff between my cheeks. And that's really not something I actually want, unless it's somebody doing it for me that I want to have done. But the reality, unfortunately, is that gaming is in fact moving into this mainstream space where people are looking more for engagement, like I said before, rather than actually just making a good and fun video game.
So do yourself a favor, get yourself an emulator, get yourself some ISOs and some ROMs, play some SNES, PS1 and PS2 games. You'll actually have a good time instead. You'll even save some money. But like I said, everyone, thank you guys so much for watching today's video. If you want to see more, subscribe to the channel. We broke 36K subs. We're on the road to 37K and even possibly 40K in 2023. So that's insane. Now, of course, we are doing more PC port reviews, gaming news, fanboy content, Steam Deck videos, and live streams every Saturday as well. So like I said, if you want to see more, subscribe. If you want to join the Discord, you can do that by becoming a YouTube member, a Patreon sub, or a Twitch sub. Just make sure everything is synced together in Discord, and you're good to go. Thank you all so much for watching. Hope you have a great one, and I'll see you next time.